Be careful with your movements. You
stay down, stay down, John. Stay down.
Stay down, John. There you go, Diego. Don't eat, eat them yourself. Give it to him. Shoot, Jacob.
Without you in it, now it is fall. Without you, I had to close the windows and doors. Without you coming through, I kept them open for as long as I could. But the baby got cold.
No, wait a second.
I watch the calendar. This whole past summer was a lingering heat wave, and I remember late August, our open bedroom. Going through your things with the fan blowing and the sound of helicopters and the smell of smoke from the forest fire that was growing, billowing just on the edge of town where we used to smell. They say a natural cleansing devastation, burning the understory, erasing trails. There is no end. But when I touch your underwear, the devastation is not natural or good. You do belong here. I reject nature. I disagree. In the hazy light of forest fire smoke, I looked across at the refineries and thought that the world was actually constantly ending. And the smell and roar of the asphalt truck that was idling just out the window, tearing up our street. I missed you, of course. And I remember thinking the last time it rained here, you were alive still. And that this same long heat that I was in contained you. And in the same heat I opened the window next to you on your last morning, so you could breathe, and then so you could ghost away. And now so the room will hopefully stop whispering. Of time, I'm not keeping up with. The leaf on the ground pokes at my slumbering grief, walking around severed lumbering. But slowly sovereignty reasserts itself. I don't want it though. And betrayal whines.
You have to be very careful.
Who and how could I live?
You have to be very careful.